Greetings, Spooky fans! Michael here, and there are quite a few gym leaders out there that I think have teams that, well, stink. That might be because they have unnecessary repeat Pokemon, Pokemon that don't fit their type specialty, not enough Pokemon from their home region, or just flat out not enough Pokemon. Today I'll be going over every gym leader that I think has a team that needs some kind of improvement and how I would fix that team. I'll say up front that I'm only looking at the species composition of these teams, not anything more particular like movesets or abilities. So, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, please! Thank you. Pick up some merch from mnjtvmerch.com, and let's dive in. First, let's talk about the Kanto gym leaders, and I'm only going to be looking at their teams in the Kanto games. As post-game gym leaders in the Johto games, their teams are pretty universally solidly diverse. Brock's team is fine, so first up is Misty. She uses a Staryu and a Starmie in almost every one of her appearances, and with all the water types out there, I think it's silly that she has a repeat. In Let's Go, though, she uses a Psyduck instead of Staryu, which I think is perfect. I think the easiest way to fix her teams is to just make the Let's Go team the one she uses in every game. Next is Lieutenant Surge. Two of his teams have a repeat with Pikachu, then his yellow team is just Raichu. Like with Misty though, his Let's Go team is much more diverse, having three unique electric types. Just make this team his team in every Kanto game and we're good to go. Erika's team is good to go, so next up is Koga, as a gym leader, not an Elite Four member. Koga's teams have always bothered me because most of them are full to the brim with repeats, which is ridiculous. Poison is the most abundant type in Kanto. Two of Koga's teams are three quarters full of members of the Weezing line, and his yellow team is entirely made up of Venomoth line members. The one team he has as a gym leader that I think is good is his Let's Go team, which uses the three poison types he uses in other teams, plus a Golbat, a Pokemon that suits him well since he goes on to have Crobat as his ace in the Johto games. Like with Misty and Lieutenant Surge, I think the easiest way to fix his bad teams is to just have his Let's Go team be his main team for all the other games. Next up is Sabrina. Two of her teams not only have a repeat Kadabra, but they also have a Venomoth, a Pokemon that is very clearly not a psychic type. Her yellow team is entirely the Alakazam line, which is just silly with all the other psychic types out there. Like with the others though, her Let's Go team is diverse and I like it a lot. Alakazam and Mr. Mime are still there, but the repeat Kadabra and not psychic Venomoth are replaced with Slowbro and Jinx, two good Kanto psychic types. Same situation as before, if this was her team in all of the generations, it'd make a lot more sense. Next is Blaine. His red, blue, fire red, and leaf green teams are half Arcanine line, half Rapidash line, so there's a lot of repeating there. Yellow is more diverse, but it drops his roster down to only three Pokemon, which I think is too few for the second to last gym leader. This is a good time for me to list out the number of Pokemon that I think each gym leader should have. Gym leaders 1 and 2 should have at least 2 Pokemon. Gyms 3, 4, and 5 should have at least 3 Pokemon. Gyms 6 and 7 should have at least 4. And Gym 8 should have at least 5. Although, basically just exactly 5, since the Elite Four members don't have 6, so Gym 8 should just have 5. Back to Blaine, though. Like with all the other gym leaders I've covered so far, I think Let's Go nails his team. It has 4 Pokemon, and all of them are unique fire types. Then the final Kanto gym leader, we're not talking about Blue, he's a post-game gym leader, and also his teams are great, is Giovanni, the only Kanto gym leader whose Let's Go team I actually think needs work. His red and blue team is almost solid, but it has a Rhyhorn, which really doesn't need to be there since he has Rhydon. His yellow team has a Persian, which I get that they included as a nod to the anime, but I still really don't think it fits. His fire red and leaf green team is the same as red and blue, but they unevolved his Rhydon, which is very stupid. Finally, in Let's Go, his team has no repeats, but it only has 4 Pokemon. And as I mentioned, I firmly believe the final gym leader should always have 5. How I think we fix this is we take his original team in red and blue and replace the Rhyhorn with Sandslash. Instead of Sandslash, we could go with Golem or Onix or Marowak, but with Golem and Onix, they're more Brock's Pokemon, and Marowak, Well, considering how Team Rocket treated Marowak earlier in the story, that would be kind of awkward.
Ha ha! It is I, Grunty Boy!
What are you here for today?
I am here to talk to you about something that's been sweeping through our culture like a tidal wave. The sponsor of this video, Raid Shadow Legends!
Why?
Because we're such good friends, and we chat about our mutual interests all the time.
Neither of those things are true.
Oh, what's that I hear? You like playing Raid Shadow Legends too? Oh, well, I knew with your excellent taste that you love this RPG. It's a game where you can battle with over 500 champions against various enemies in the campaign, big bosses in the dungeons, or other players in the PvP arena. It's so fun to collect more champions, and they can be made stronger by equipping gear onto them, training them up in the campaign, or sacrificing your weaker ones.
Yeah, I know. You know I've played the game. Why are you telling me stuff that I already know?
Mutual interests, buddy! Also, I wanted to tell you that you can get Ninja as a champion, but only until October 15th, so you have to hurry. Also, they just released new clan features, like quests and benefits for just being in a clan, plus new champions to collect from fragments in the Doom Tower.
Ugh, seriously, Grunty Boy, you can't just be telling me all this because you want to have a casual chat. What do you want?
I just wanted to tell you that if you click the link in the description below or scan the QR code on screen, new players will get an epic hero Chinoru, who is amazing in the Doom Tower, 200,000 silver, 1 XP boost, 1 energy refill, and 1 ancient shard so you can summon an awesome champion as soon as you get in game. But you only have 30 days.
Come on, man, what's really going on?
I'm just here to ask you to join my clan. I need help.
Yeah, sure, I don't mind. Why didn't you just say that to start with?
Oh, I don't know. It was a weird thing, I guess. You know, I'm just normally so good at asking my mortal enemy, a very good friend, for help. I'm gonna go now. Anyways, ta-ta!
Well, all right then. Anyways, thanks so much to Raid Shadow Legends for sponsoring this video. But now, let's get back to it. Now on to Johto, the group of gym leaders that inspired this video, because they almost all of them have bad teams. Like, so many of them don't use any Johto Pokemon? What? First up is Faulkner. His team is just Pidgey and Pidgeotto, no Johto birds to be found. My first instinct is to replace Pidgeotto with Noctowl, but Noctowl is much stronger than Pidgeotto, and stronger than every other first gym ace Pokemon, aside from Milo's Eldegoss. Milo is a very late first gym leader though, whereas Faulkner is very early, so I think Noctowl would be unfair. Instead, I think swapping Pidgey for Hoot Hoot works well. However, I think an ideal team would be Hoot Hoot and Murkrow. Murkrow isn't too powerful, and both are Johto Pokemon. Next is Bugsy. Like Faulkner, he uses no Johto Pokemon, which bothers me. First, I'd replace Metapod and Kakuna with Ladybug and Spinarak. To be clear, I think it's fine if Johto gym leaders have Kanto Pokemon on their team, but with Bugsy specifically, why focus on Kakuna and Metapod when you've got Ladybug and Spinarak, the new region's new bug types that you could focus on instead? For Bugsy's and all the other gym leaders' aces, I prefer for them to be Pokemon from the leader's home region, which means replacing Scyther. To give Bugsy an ace on the same power level as Scyther from Johto, we need either Heracross or Scizor, since weirdly enough, Scyther and Scizor have the exact same base stat total. I think Scizor's typing is too good for this early in the game, so I think Heracross works best as Bugsy's new ace. As for Whitney, she is the only Johto gym leader whose team I actually think is totally fine. Her ace is a Johto Pokemon, and she has no repeats. Now, I know she only has 2 Pokemon when I did say I think the third gym leader should have at least 3, but with Whitney specifically, her Miltank is like 3 Pokemon by itself, so I think she's fine. Next up is Morty, and his entire team is repeats, but that's not completely his fault. The only Kanto and Johto ghost types are the Gengar line and Mistrevis. That being said, it is ridiculous that they did not give him a Mistrevis. To fix his team, I think we replace the Gastly with a Mistrevis. While I prefer the gym leader's ace Pokemon to be from their home region, Mistrevis is much weaker than Gengar, so I don't think it makes sense as his ace. Even if the Mistrevis was higher level than Gengar, I think the Gengar would still be stronger. Next up is Chuck, Despite being in the second half of Gym Leaders, he only has two Pokemon, and neither of them are Johto Pokemon. The first thing to easily do is add on Hitmontop and make it his ace. I think that's all that's really necessary, since I don't think four Pokemon becomes necessary until we move to the sixth gym leader. Next is Jasmine. I hate her team. She has the spicy new steel type and the cool ace Steelix, but then the rest of her team is just two Magnemites. What is she doing? There are so many cool steel types available that she could use instead. First, let's swap out one of the Magnemites for Skarmory, a steel type no other major boss fight in Johto uses. Then we can keep the other Magnemite, since I think it's cool to show how its type changed from Gen 1, but it should be evolved, since it's at the level where it would evolve. Finally, since she's the sixth gym leader, I think she needs four Pokemon. For the last one, I suggest Scizor. And before you say that it overlaps with Bugsy's ace, Bugsy's ace is Heracross now. Next up is Price, the gym leader strangely labeled as the seventh, but with a team the same level as Chuck and weaker than Jasmine. The level curves in the Johto games with like trainers levels and wild Pokemon, they're very messed up. I think he needs his levels increased across the board, but also the roster needs work. Seal should clearly be replaced, and I think it should be with Delibird, which actually has almost the same base stat total. Finally, he needs a fourth Pokemon since he's gym number 7, and Sneasel is an easy pick for the last Pokemon here. Finally is Claire, and she is in a weird spot. She is the 8th gym leader, and in my opinion, the final gym leader should always have 5 Pokemon. However, due to her specialty being dragon type, she is extremely limited in options. Her existing team has a pair of repeats and a Pokemon that is not dragon type, but there's not much we can do to improve that due to the extremely limited options. It's a bit goofy, but if I had to add a fifth Pokemon, I think a good fit would be Lapras. It's considered dragon-like since Iris uses it as champion, and it doesn't overlap with the dragon-like but not dragon Pokemon that Lance uses, being Charizard and Aerodactyl. Gyarados does overlap with Lance, but like, what else are we gonna do, guys? Why did they make two dragon specialists in a game with only two fully evolved dragon types? Next, let's talk about the Hoenn gym leaders. Roxanne's teams are fine. Her Emerald team didn't need to add the extra Geodude, so I actually prefer the Ruby and Sapphire team to avoid the repeat. Brawly's teams are also fine. I like his Emerald team a bit more, but his Ruby Sapphire team is fine. And then we get to Watson. His Emerald team is solid, but his other teams infuriate me. A pair of repeats and no Hoenn Pokemon? I kind of get some of the Johto gym leaders not having any Johto Pokemon, since Johto was very much treated more like an expansion of Kanto rather than a totally fresh region, because all the Kanto Pokemon basically are available in Johto, but Hoenn is its own new place far away. Why is a Hoenn gym leader only using Kanto Pokemon? Watson's Emerald team is far better. It still has a repeat, but the repeat is a Hoenn Pokemon, and his ace is now an appropriate Manectric. To make the team perfect though, I say swap out Voltorb and Electrike for Plusle and Minun. He'd have even more Hoenn Electric types and no repeats. Next up is Flannery. Her Ruby Sapphire team is very bad. Why two Slugmas when Numel is a very obvious option? Her Emerald team is cool, but I think the underleveled Camerupt is unnecessary. Her Aurus team is acceptable though, as I don't think she needs four Pokemon at the Gym 4 position. I think she'd be in good shape if her Aurus team was her team across the board, or her Emerald team with the Camerupt replaced by Vulpix. Next up is Norman. His non-Emerald teams are awful, entirely repeats within the Slaking line. I do think having both Slaking and Vigoroth is fine, since they have very different fighting styles and it's a cool way to kind of show that off, but having the other Slaking, that's just silly. His Emerald team is fine though. It does have the repeat of Vigoroth and Slaking, but as I just said, I think that's a fine repeat. We just make his Emerald team his team everywhere, we're good to go. I don't really have any major gripes with Winona's team, but I have a small issue with her Emerald team. Her non-Emerald teams are great, but her Emerald team has Swablu. She'd be perfect if her Emerald team just removed the Swablu, or she just used her non-Emerald team. Tate and Liza's Emerald team is perfect, but I have to bring them up because their non-Emerald team is just Solrock and Lunatone. Entirely too few Pokemon. Emerald perfected their team, so it frustrates me that they did not keep it that way in Orris. Make their Emerald team their everywhere team, and they're good to go. Finally, I have no issues whatsoever with Wallace's and Juan's gym leader teams. Both of them use 5 Pokemon that are all completely unique. I suppose Juan's ace could be a Hoenn water type like Gorbis instead of Kingdra, but that Kingdra is so infuriatingly tough to fight that I think it's actually perfect as the ace of the final gym leader. So many double teams. And rest. This Kingdra is tougher than most of the Elite Four Pokemon. Next up is Sinnoh, and they did a far better job with most of their gym leaders compared to the previous regions. I have zero issues with the teams for the first 5 gym leaders. Rourke, Gardenia, Fantina, Maylene, and Wake. However, then we get to Byron. While I think both his teams are fine in the composition part, as the 6th gym leader, I think he needs a 4th Pokemon. When selecting new Pokemon for a Sinnoh leader's team, I will be selecting from the Platinum Dex, even if I'm trying to fix their Diamond and Pearl team. That's because I have a moral opposition to the Diamond and Pearl Pokedex because it is terrible, doesn't include so many of the new Pokemon, and is way too limited. It's just awful. A lot of trainers in Diamond and Pearl have bad teams just because the Dex is bad, not because they had better options and didn't use them. Also, for the Sinnoh leaders, they're gonna have access to the Platinum Dex in the upcoming remakes, Brilliant Diamond, Shining Pearl. So like, I'm picking from the Platinum Dex. With access to the Platinum Dex, it makes filling out his team very easy. Simply take the Bronze Ore from his Diamond and Pearl team and put it on his Platinum team, and you're good to go. Well, actually, I think it should be evolved into a Bronzong since it is above its evolution level. Next is Candace, but I'm actually deciding not to count her here. Her Diamond and Pearl team is clearly awful, but her Platinum team is great. If Diamond and Pearl had the Platinum Dex from the beginning, we would have had her Platinum team from the beginning. So you know what, let's just pretend her Diamond and Pearl team just doesn't exist. Finally is Volkner. Once again, an awful Diamond and Pearl team, only being half electric type, but a very solid Platinum team. He only has 4 Pokemon though, which I do not like. Toss on a Magnezone though, and he's good to go. Next up is Unova. The triplets, Lenora, Charon, and Roxy all have fine teams in my book. Berg has a great team in Black and White, but his Black 2 and White 2 team has a completely unnecessary repeat. I get that they replaced his Whirlipede since Whirlipede is Roxy's ace, but they have so many other options they could have used instead of a repeat Swadloon. Just give him a Karrablast like he uses on his challenge mode team. Elise's Black 2 and White 2 team is fine, but her original Black and White team repeats Emolga's for no good reason. I say replace one of them with a Tynamo. It has no weaknesses, but I still think it's fair since it's much weaker than Emolga, and also she uses one in the anime. Clay's teams are both totally fine. Skyla's teams are good in composition, but she needs another Pokemon. An easy way to do that is to add Sigilyph to both teams. It's yet another psychic flying type, but my options for Black and White flying types are pretty limited. Bryson also has good composition, but not enough Pokemon. The problem here is that in Black and White, he's already using a member from every non-legendary ice type line in the Black and White Unova decks. I don't like it, but I value number of Pokemon more than repeats, so I think adding a Cubchu works best. It evolves into Beartick at level 37, so a level 36 one would be logical. Next, we need to talk about the kind of weird situation with Drayden and Iris, since their gym position changes depending on the version. So first, let's talk about Drayden and Iris together as 8th gym leaders in Black and White. They are the final gym leaders, yet they only have 3 Pokemon. They need 2 more Pokemon, but the Unova Dragon types are very limited. First, I think we can add on a Zweilous. It would be under its evolution level, but gym leaders and Elite Four members do that all the time. And also, its evolution level is stupid. Think of this as a protest against Dino's evolution levels. For the 5th Pokemon, I'd give them Archaeops. Obviously, it's not a dragon type, but it's dragon-like, and Iris does go on to use one as champion. There really isn't anything I can do about the repeat fracture due to our options being so limited, so this is as good as it's getting. Then in Black 2 and White 2, Drayden is the 7th gym leader, so he only requires 4 Pokemon. Altaria is a dragon type in the Black 2, White 2 decks, so that's the clear choice to add. Finally for Unova is Marlin. who only has 3 Pokemon despite being the final gym leader. I have a ton of options for water types though, but I'm going with Seismitoad and Mantine, chosen mostly arbitrarily. Next up is Kalos, and I've actually discussed my problems with a lot of the Kalos gym leaders in my Pokemon X and Y's biggest problems video. So if any of this sounds familiar, that's because you've watched the other video. Viola's team is perfectly fine, since most first gym leaders only have 2 Pokemon. I also think Grant is fine. I think a third Pokemon like Binacle would suit him well, since he's the highest level second gym leader, but I don't think it's absolutely necessary. Karina's team composition and number of Pokemon is fine. They need better movesets, but that's not the focus of this video. Ramos' team is fine, but I think a Trevenant could have been added or swapped in for the Weepin' Bell. Clement's team is also fine, with a fourth Pokemon like Dedenne fitting well, but not being absolutely necessary. Valerie's team definitely needs work though. In my old video, I replaced Mawile due to its poor moveset and instead had her use Florges, and then added on Granbull. I think this would be a much better team, but I also think Mawile is fine to keep if it is actually given stab moves. Olympia also needs a fourth Pokemon. In my previous video, I added on Malamar, since it's the only non-starter, non-mythical psychic type introduced in Gen 6 that she doesn't already have. I also think a male Meowstic would work well. While technically a repeat, it's a different form and battles differently. Finally for Kalos is Wolfric. One of, if not the, most egregiously bad 8th gym leader teams in all of Pokemon. Sure, he only has 3 Pokemon, as do the 8th gym leaders in the Unova region. And Drayden and Iris have repeats. Yes, their teams are bad too. But with Wolfric, there is one specific thing that makes his team extra bad. He doesn't have a Mega Evolution. I talk about it in more detail in my X and Y's biggest problem video, but in short, I hate that Mega Evolution is the central mechanic of Pokemon X and Y, yet so few boss battles have them. I get why Mega Evolution isn't throughout the entire game because so many of them are extremely strong and maybe you don't have a fully evolved team yet, but once you fight Lysander and his Mega Gyarados, every major boss battle for the rest of the game should have a Mega Evolution. Your team is over level 50. They should basically all be fully evolved. You have Mega Evolution yourself. The training wheels should be off. But instead, the only Mega Evolutions you fight throughout the main story are Mega Lucario versus Mega Lucario, Lysander's Mega Gyarados, and the champion's Mega Gardevoir. No Megas in the Elite Four, no Mega for the 8th gym leader, and I think that's so dumb. To fix Wolfric's team, the easiest change is making the Abomasnow a Mega Abomasnow, like he has in the anime. Look at that, the writers of the anime knew what to do to make things interesting. In my previous video, I added a Mamoswine and left his team like that since other 8th gym leaders do only have 4 Pokemon. But for this video, I want all of the 8th gym leaders to have 5, so I'll add on a Cloyster. Next, we move on to Sword and Shield, which means, yes, I am skipping Alola. In most of my other videos where I talk about gym leaders, I count the Kahunas as gym leaders, but my whole system with how many Pokemon they should have really breaks down with the Kahunas because the numbering system is different. In Sword and Shield, Milo uses both Eldegoss and Gossifleur. Considering that he uses Gigantamax Flapple or Appleton later in the game, replacing the Gossifleur with Applin makes so much more sense. And yeah, it's a dragon type in the first gym of the game. A dragon type with 6 weaknesses, you'll be fine. After Milo though, I have no other issues with all of the other Sword and Shield gym leaders. They did a really good job of giving them diverse teams with enough Pokemon and having their aces be new Galar Pokemon. And yes, new Gigantamax forms count as new Galar Pokemon. And yes, that includes Raihan. Despite the fact that he's the last gym leader and only has 4 Pokemon, when I've said the last gym leader should have 5. I am okay with his team because my reason for wanting 5 Pokemon for the final gym leader is the added difficulty. And Raihan's battle is already difficult by nature of being a double battle. A battle format playthrough teams are rarely built for. Additionally, him having 4 Pokemon is a nod to the number of Pokemon you can bring to a competitive double battle, which Raihan's battle is kind of intended to show off. Plus, it's not easy to give him a 5th Pokemon. There aren't any other dragon types in the Galar decks, that are not hurt by sandstorm. So there we have it. I fixed everything. Feel free to hire me, Game Freak. I'd do a good job of making these teams. I think. Anyways, thanks so much for watching, and an extra special thanks to my patrons over on Patreon. We're helping support my channel independent of fluctuating YouTube ad rates. If you want to help support me in the same way, the link is in the description below. Also, if you want to check out some more of my fun Pokemon content, I recommend these videos here. All right, that's all I have for now. So till next time, fans, gotta catch them all.